Great here. Welcome back to Factorio. We are so close to robots. I can taste it. Okay, so do I have logistics robots? I believe I do. I need my science pack 3s. So close. Okay, so for the time being, this is where the extent of my Factorio experience really starts to break down, because you notice how over here on this side it's all nice and orderly and I know what's going on, and the further I go into Factorio, the messier it gets. Yeah, that's pretty much... I mean, I'm only coming up on like 80 hours in the game. This is not a lot. So, what I'm actually going to do is I am going to start getting robots in the air. And to do that, I'm going to build them by hand. I need more advanced circuits. I've only got 25. I need another bunch. Now, these are producing as fast as they can. Maybe I could do something here to get this... to get this line working better. You know what? Yeah, let's do this. Okay, I need... I know I just built all of this, but... I don't need... that. So that'll keep running for a while. Get this. Okay, so what I'm gonna do... is... we are going to have... path here. And that's going to be the offload. So, I don't need that power there. Yeah, I definitely don't need that power there. Wait, I do. But I'm going to put it in on the inside. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to have... a belt here. And a belt here. Okay? And we are just going to cram these out. Let's put 4. Lasers are done. Nice, nice, nice. Stack inserters. Explosives I'm not worried about. Laser turrets. I need laser turrets. Okay. Okay. So, this... goes up to here. And I need a batch of these. There. Okay. So now, it's getting dark. I need light. There. Okay. So, what I will then do is have inputs here. Like so. And I need one more here. Where are... and I will have long-handed inserters output, because long-handed inserters will definitely keep up with the demand. Like so. And then I think, can I put a poor man's load balancer here? No. but I can do it like that. Okay. So there are my advanced circuits. Which I could just... I need more. Advanced circuits, you just need a ton of. Okay, so... Do I have 45 on me right now? Yes, I do. Let's get our first RoboPort out. I need gears. There we go. Where's our first RoboPort? There it is. It's glorious. And where do I want to put it? Can I actually... If I put it here, what? Yeah, it runs into the path. Well, I need to put it somewhere. That's going to be all lined up, so I'm reserving this space. I did not think this through. Or did I? I know where what I'm going to do with it. You know, having it intrude onto the path is not going to be that bad. So our first RoboPort is going to go right there. Okay, there it is. It's glorious. Okay, so next step. I need one deconstruction planner, which I'm going to put here and lock it in place. And I need advanced circuits, like so. I need a blueprint book, which I am going to put next to my... Stop. There we go. Lock that in place. And a blueprint. And the blueprint... Let's see, how to, right to open up. There we go. And I can move my blueprint into there. Good, good, good. Okay. So, what this lets me do is I can now put the book down because I need construction robots. Where are my construction robots? I can build those. I can build the frames in hand. I need electric engines, batteries, and circuits. I'm building these in hand because I want robots right now. Okay, get a bunch of batteries. Let's get half of the electric engines. Why is this shut down? It's not. Okay, so I can now make flying frames. So let's make 5 flying frames. In fact, these require 4 inputs, which means I need to make them in hand anyway. Actually, let's stop there, because I want a robot. Okay, where's my construction robot? Construction robot. There we go. There's my construction robot. And what you do is you throw it in the air. And it goes to the RoboPort. Ta-da! Okay, we need 5 more frames. Okay, while I'm working on those frames, what I can now do is take this deconstruction planner and say, hey, let's get rid of all of this. And it says, okay, I will get rid of all of that. I have no place to put it, because I have to give it a storage chest. So let's get the storage chest. Where is it? There. So we're going to put a storage chest right here. And what it's going to do is it's going to grab everything off of here, move it over, and it will deconstruct everything. which is nice. The other thing that it can do is if I run over here, and this is the big thing, and I grab a whole bunch of these, yeah, that's passive provider chest. Oh, I can make passive provider chests. Let's make 5 of those real quick. And I've got another frame, so I can make another construction robot and throw him in the air. There we go. And he will fly. So, now, where are my passive provider chests? They're right here. So, what we can do now is make this a passive provider chest, make that a passive provider chest. All of these will be passive provider chests. I need 2 more. What these do is they allow robots to pick things up out of them. So now that I've got this in the network as a passive provider chest, the robots are aware that those are there. So what I can do is now take the book and say, hey, I want a good run of just yellow transport belt. And create that blueprint. And I can say, hey, please generate these. However, I think... yeah. That chest over there is outside the network. So, give me more of these. Please and thank you. We need another RoboPort, which I can make. Okay. I'm so happy for this. This is going to be glorious. Yeah, so this is telling me, hey, you've got 40 things that I'm trying to build. I don't have the materials for it. So then we take the RoboPort that we just built, and the yellow area is the logistics network, which are the other class of robots. And the green area is the... what am I thinking of? The construction range. So we're actually just going to put this right here. Okay, so we need power. Where's our power? I really should... a lot of things I should do. Okay, so let's... power up this RoboPort. So now, these robots, they came over here, and notice how they grabbed the transport belt, and they're now going to place it down over here. Which is excellent. It is perfect. Okay, let's make some more flying frames. Yes, these are slow. This is the very first generation of robot. It's going to take them forever to fly back and forth. However, I no longer need to actually construct any of this. This will be taken care of by the robots. You know, and I can say, hey, I want more running out like this. I can rotate these, which is really, really useful. Okay, my laser turrets are finished. Perfect. Okay. Logistics system requires science pack 3s. I don't think I can make those yet. Where do I make my science pack 3s? Advanced material processing. Concrete. Accumulators I don't need. Worker robot. All of that needs blue science. Stack inserters. Nope, blue science isn't off of that. Laser turret damage. Well, let's get that going. Combat robotics I'm not interested in. Modules. So, can I make blue science right now? Oh, I can! Interesting. Okay, so here I need batteries, advanced circuits, filter inserters, and steel plates. Well, my batteries are all the way down on this side of the this side of the bus. Steel plate is easy enough to get. Okay. Advanced circuits are on that side of the bus. Filter inserters require... Yeah, beep, 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 beep. Filter inserters require fast inserters plus... Oh, I hate this so much. And I bet you it takes forever to make all that by hand, doesn't it? Although I can make 16! Ugh. And steel. Filter inserters require regular inserters. Okay, where's my... I know I've got some frames in here. There we go. So I want to make more construction robots. There we go. So only having a couple of robots up in the air means that this takes forever. However, you can have hundreds upon thousands of these little guys flying through the air. Oof, okay. I have to make 150... Okay. Turret lasers complete. Nice, nice, nice. Let's work. Yeah, 150 blue science by hand. Okay, what has dried up here? My plastic. My plastic is no longer being made because I've got petroleum gas. Ah, the coal. That's why. Well, while I'm running around, let's get this taken care of. Let's just suck up as much coal as we can. Okay. Yeah, literally as much coal as I could. Oh, wait, plastic's down here. Do I have... And I'm out of crude, so I should make a crude run right after this. Okay. So, construction robots, what they do is they build and repair things that you in your base. Logistics robots are what move things around the network. So, the idea here is eventually I'm going to have a roboport down there in that oil area. And I'm going to use logistics robots to run the oil barrels up to here, so I no longer need to make this oil run. In addition to that, logistics robots can pull things out of providers, these provider chests, and go to other chests, and they can make sure that they can also go into your inventory. So I could say, hey, I always want 200 of these in my inventory at all time, and the logistics robots will take care of it. That's why I've been pushing for robots so hard. It's because I want to get this taken care of. Unfortunately, I wait a minute. These take four, so I wouldn't. These only take three inputs, right? Oh no, these take four. I can build these. Okay. Well, for the time being, let's see. Yeah, what I'm going to do is I'm going to, just place one right here for now. And batteries. Let's get a whole bunch of steel plates. There we go. We'll give you the steel. And in fact, I'm going to... Wow, I just ran myself out of everything, didn't I? Okay. Steel. Advanced circuits, batteries. Okay. So let's get the advanced circuits. Let's get the batteries. And advanced circuits is running again. Okay. Where? Oh, it's back here. This is the chest that I want. Okay. So... Advanced circuits, steel, batteries. Need more batteries. Okay, there's a bunch of batteries, bunch of steel, bunch of circuits. Grab more steel from here. I'm just loading everything up in here. Okay, now I need to make a ton of filter inserters. And I'll make those by hand. Except... There. I don't want to make the circuits by hand. Because I have circuits here. There we go. Okay, that's enough right there. And now, here, we'll have an output, and we'll have a bunch... Oops, wrong direction. And this is why I have this particular layout. Let's take half of these out. Okay, so we're on our way to getting logistics taken care of. I need more of these. I need inserters all the way around. There we go. And actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this here. Give it the batteries, give it the advanced circuits, give it the steel and the inserters. We'll put another there. Okay, and it needs power. Give me power. So at least this way I'm not making them by hand. And let's actually make these fast inserters. There we go. Okay, so the idea is this will get the blue science up and running. It's not going to be enough to keep all of these going, but it will be enough for now. Then, what that will let me do is it will get me the full logistics network up and running. And with the full logistics network, let's grab just all of these. With the full logistics network, I can then use logistics robots to move items around. And since I have stuff on this end of the bus that I need to move backwards to this end of the bus, I can do that with logistics robots. That will basically kickstart all of this. Once I get enough logistics robots, things will go happy, happy. So, I'm going to put a cut in here. I hope you enjoyed today's video, as slow as it is, and I promise things are going to pick up. Have fun.